Hi everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to print both even and odd numbers by using for loop in Python. So let's get started. So first we will be getting the number in as an input from the user, so that n equal to int of input, enter a number, that's it, and don't leave space, and have here int because this is going to be of type integer, and if you just neglect this int, this is going to be treated as a type string. So just have here int. And next thing, let me just have a simple for loop at first. So it's going to be for I in range 0 comma n, which is the number that we got input. And let me just print I, that's it. So let me just first run this program and show you how we can improvise this code. So let me just go with 10. So at first, here you can see we are getting the output from 0 to 9, okay? This should not happen basically because 0 is a neutral number and we are getting only till 9, but the input is 10. So we need to also find a way to include 10 and neglect 0. So for that, what we can do is we can just have the range from 1 till n plus 1, okay? So because basically in Python, for takes till the range minus 1. So if you just give n over here, it will just take 1 till n minus 1 by default. If you also want that nth term, you need to give it as n plus 1. So I'm saving it. And if you run it now, yeah. So I'll be getting 1 till 10. Perfect. So first, let me show you how we can print the odd numbers. And later that, I will show you how you can print the even numbers, okay? So first thing here, by default, we are incrementing the number by 1. So in a for loop, the syntax is basically range. This is going to be the starting value and this is going to be the ending value. And we have a third parameter, which is the increment. So we don't give that increment usually if you want that increment by 1. So if I just go here and put a comma and if I just go and give here 1, we will be getting the same thing in the output. We will be getting the numbers from 1 to 10 because by default the increment is 1. What I mean by increment is that first, during the first iteration of the for loop, 1 gets printed, 1 goes here, it gets incremented by 1, that is I equal to I plus 1. This is what basically happens, I equal to I plus 1 happens each time. It goes here, 1 gets printed, I equal to 1 plus 1 which is 2, 2 gets printed, I equal to 2 plus 1, 3 gets printed, I equal to 3 plus 1, 4 gets printed. It just goes on. The value just gets incremented by 1. So we will be incrementing the value now by 2. Okay. Or I will just show you with 5. Okay. I'll just go with 5 now. So I'll just show you and run this now. Let me go with 30. And here you can see what has happened. 1, 6, 11, 16, 21 and 26. The reason is because 1 gets printed, I equal to 1 plus 5 which is 6. 6 gets printed, I equal to 6 plus 5, 11. So basically we are incrementing by 5. And now for printing the odd numbers, we just need to have here the incrementation as 2 and the initial value should be 1 because this is super important. The initial value is super, super important. And now this is going to be like this. If I save it and if I run it now, let me go with 10 again. So here you can see this time we will be getting the odd numbers alone because the incrementation is 2. 1 gets printed, I equal to 1 plus 2, 3. 3 gets printed, I equal to 3 plus 2, 5. Okay. So basically when we add 2 to an odd number, that will give us the next odd number to that number. So next odd number to 1 is 3. Next odd number to 3 is 5. And we will be getting the next odd number of a number when we add 2. That's it. That's the reason why we are getting the consecutive odd numbers here. So this is fine. This works fine for odd numbers. So let us see what we can do for even numbers, okay? So let me just now copy this exact same code and let me just now comment this. Yeah, I'll just comment this and I'll just paste it, okay? And I'll clear this. So for even number, it is going to be a single number change, okay? A single number change. So for printing the even numbers, just change the starting value from 1 to 2. That's it. So now this program prints the even numbers. If I save it and this is commented, so this won't run. If I run this, I will go with 10 and I'm getting 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. This is printing us the even numbers right now. And the reason is because it starts from 2. It doesn't start from 1. If we start from 1, what I told you earlier, if we add 2 to an odd number, that will give us the line or list of odd numbers. So this will go on like 1, 3, 5, 7 till our value n. So because of this operation. And the same thing, if we add 2 to an even number, that will give us the next even number to that number. So if I add 2 to 2, it gives us 4. 4 plus 2 gives us 6. 6 plus 2 gives us 8. So exact same thing applies for even numbers also. So 2, 4, 6, 8, and it just goes on to n. So only the starting value matters. Okay, if the starting value is an odd number, this is going to give us a list of odd numbers. And if the starting value is an even number like 2, this is going to give us the list of even numbers. I hope this made sense. So now let's see how we can print both. So I'll just uncomment this and let me have the variable name as I for printing the even numbers, and let me just change this to J. Alright, just change this to J. Don't have the same variable, it may cause some confusion. Just change J here also and make sure that you are having one for odd numbers and two for even numbers. And let me just also have a print. Okay, why am I copying that? Let me go with print, and it's going to be odd numbers. Copy this, paste it, and have it as even numbers. That's it. Saving it, clearing and running it now. Let me go with 20. So here you can see I'm getting the odd numbers 1 till 19 and from 2 to 20. So that's it guys. This is the code for how you print both even and odd numbers by using a for loop in Python. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of tutorials in Python, C, C++, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL queries. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.